32nd Sunday in ordinary time, to serve people unconditionally and bear true witness to God's kingdom, we must be spiritually prepared. Since all preparation requires discipline and sacrifice, God invites us to a life of simplicity and humility, to be always connected to Him in prayer and guidance from the Holy Spirit. Today's gospel encourages us to be alert and be focused to our purpose of life and become true witness of Christ to all around us. Let us at this Eucharistic celebration pray to the Holy Spirit to help us face God without guilt or shame and be always alert and prepared to welcome Him with the lighted torches of a life spent in faithful service to Him. Then He will invite us to walk with Him into the feast of eternal life. Today, Goraito Zone celebrates their annual Thanksgiving. Let us pray for the members of this zone.
Kindly take your hymn books to hymn number 31. Kindly rise.
This Mass is offered for the intentions of the parishioners and also for Goraito Zone, who celebrates the annual Thanksgiving Mass in this Eucharist. And their patron saint is Saint Martin the Porus. Let us pray for all those who are in that zone, that following the example of Saint Martin the Porus, they may also, like him, be humble enough, simple, and let them work the works of charity, and especially the poor. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kindly take your hymn books to hymn number 470. Kindly join us in the Gloria.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
Let us pray. O God, who led Saint Martin the Porous by the path of humility for heavenly glory, grant that we may so follow his radiant example in this life as to merit to be exalted with him in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Wisdom. Wisdom is bright and does not grow dim. By those who love her, she is readily seen and found by those who look for her. Quick to anticipate those who desire her, she makes herself known to them. Watch for her early and you will have no trouble. You will find her sitting at your gates. Even to think about her is understanding fully grown. Be on the alert for her, and anxiety will leave you. She herself walks about looking for those who are worthy of her, and graciously shows herself to them as they go, in every thought of theirs, coming to meet them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly join us in the responsorial psalm.
my soul is thirsting.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them, like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teaching, that any of us who are left alive until the Lord's coming will not have any advantage over those who have died. At the trumpet of God, the voice of the archangel will call out the command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise, and then those of us who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly take your hymn books to hymn number 592. Kindly rise.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told this parable to his disciples. The kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, and 5 were sensible. The foolish ones did not take their lamps, but they took their lamps, but they brought no oil. Whereas the sensible one took flask of oil as well as their lamps. The bridegroom was late, and they all grew drowsy and fell asleep. But at midnight there was a call, "The bridegroom is here, go out and meet him." At this, all the bridesmaids woke up and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish ones said to the sensible ones, "Give us some of your oil, our lamps are going out." But they replied, "They may not be enough for us and for you. You had better go to those who sell it and buy some for yourself." They had gone off to buy it when the bridegroom arrived. Those who were ready went in with him to the wedding hall, and the door was closed. The other bridesmaids arrived later. "Lord, Lord," they said, "open the door for us." But he replied, "I tell you solemnly, I do not know you. So stay awake, because you do not know either the day or the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, as we are celebrating this Thanksgiving Eucharist on behalf of the Gorai 2 zone, let us pray on the Word of God and reflect on the Word of God. Very beautiful and very nice. The first reading is taken from the Book of Wisdom, and wisdom is found by those who look for her. Wisdom is always found when we look for her. As the Lord has said, "Search and you will find." And wisdom, to see wisdom, we need one essential characteristic, that is love. Love is such a beautiful thing. And when we have love in us, we can see wisdom. Wisdom never grows old. It never grows dim. Wisdom is always alive. So be alert and know what wisdom is doing and what wisdom means to us. This is what the first reading is telling us today. It's telling us that we need to have love. We need to always not to grow dim, never lose our hope, and then be alert and also not be afraid. The second reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Thessalonians, it just says plainly, "Do not grieve about those who died in Jesus. Because all of us who have died in Jesus, baptized in the name of Jesus, lived a life on the principle of Jesus, participated in this Eucharist, we never have to be afraid of death. In this COVID pandemic 19, so many of our brethren, so many of our friends, those whom we know and we don't know, have lost their life. And Jesus is telling here, in a special way, through Saint Paul, do not grieve. Be happy because you believed in Christ, and all those people who have died are living with Christ. Therefore, do not grieve. Do not lose hope, because our hope in Christ, because Jesus, who suffered, who died, who was buried, and then he rose again, and he has told us that the same promise he has given us, that this will happen to us. And therefore, the hope of being one day with God the Father, with Jesus and the Holy Spirit. The third reading of today from the Gospel of Saint Matthew, chapter 25, the wise and the foolish virgins. All of us know, if I ask you a basic question, which virgin you want to be, or which group you want to join, you will say, of course, the wise ones. We will carry the flask of oil. As I will tell you later, that oil represents preparation to be with the bridegroom. That means if I choose to be with the wise people, then I need to prepare myself for that, prepare myself to be with Jesus. The bridesmaids took their lamps, all of them, all 10 of them took their lamps. Some took oil, 5 of them, and 5 of them did not take. And at midnight, there is a cry, and cry is of awakening. Get up! My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, all of us these days, you want the Mass to be relayed at 8:39 because in the morning we need to sleep. Nobody wants to get up. No one wants to get up. There was one author who said, we are born in the sleep and we live our life in the sleep. We study, we work, we do everything in our sleep. Ultimately, one day we die in our sleep. We have to be awake. We have to get up. The cry at that moment, at midnight, is cry of awakening. It is the miracle, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, of awareness that you are awake. You know what is happening. You close your eyes in your awakening and you notice every single sound of the universe you will be listening to. This is what happens. This is what happened to the saints. So many of the saints like that. Francis of Assisi simply could hear the birds and all those things. It is because of the awareness. He was awakened. He left a life. There was a turning point when he embraced the leper and never he turned back. Always one with Jesus. Always the miracle of living with Jesus, for Jesus and doing his work as well. The second cry, the second thing is, as soon as they get up, they start trimming. They start trimming. The trimming of the lamps is something specific. They are planning to do something specific. Even if we join in the trimming, which part of our life needs trimming? It is shaping the hedges. Which part of our lives which needs shaping the edges? Where we need to be decisive and forceful to take a stand and to decide. Once I'm aware, I need to trim myself. I need to prune myself. I need to just shape myself in such a way that I decide something which is good for Christ, which is on the teachings, on the lines of Jesus Christ which he has taught us. Trimming can mean specific, trimming can mean decisive, trimming can make shape the whole thing. Sometimes we are so happy, supposing you pass a comment, my God, in this lockdown period, you are looking slim and trim and fit. All of us are happy. Let us also make slim and trim and fit for Jesus in this lockdown period, in this lockdown period. The third cry, arrival, arrival. Jesus has arrived. The bridegroom has arrived. Where have we arrived in this lockdown period? We have so many plans. All the plans are only to do with money and with job loss and relationships. Because we cannot meet, we try to meet. What is our arrival? Where are we arriving at in this period of lockdown? Reaching, arrival means reaching a place, reaching a destination, setting a goal and to be at it. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, ready or not, here I am. Ready or not, here I come to Jesus. Ready or not, I am with the bridegroom. Ready or not, I am there. This is what we need to do. This is what we need to do. Of course, the oil which we have in that cry where they need the flask of oil to put is the preparation. And therefore, whether I am prepared or not, I am going to be there with Jesus. This is what we need to do. We need to prepare ourselves. Of course, the door may get shut. Of course, we have to knock. And Jesus, in one of the readings, one of the parables, has said, "Knock and it shall be opened to you." And there's a beautiful picture of the Sacred Heart which shows many doors that He is knocking, but the door only is not opening because we are not listening to Him. We are not listening to Him. And today, as this Gurai 2 celebrates the feast of Saint Martin the Porous, he applied himself at a very young age because he found that he was not worthy to join the Dominicans as a helper, he said. And later on, after 9 years, he became a brother. He was an example of his prayer life. He was an example of doing penance. He was an example of doing charity and humility. Most of the works which were there in that houses which he went, there he was in charge of the poor and he really helped the poor. His days were filled with charity and working, serving the poor, serving the sick. Whereas his nights were filled and nights were spent specially in prayer and in penance so that he could achieve, he could pray to Jesus, get the strength, and he could do the rest. He founded an orphanage, and regardless of the color, of the race and status, he looked after them. That's why he is known as the patron of the Africans and the Americans, the African Americans. He is known as the patron of hairdressers, of race relationships, of social justice, so many things he is the patron of, especially because he lived a life of poor. My dear brothers and sisters, just a small video clipping I had seen, which I like to narrate to you today. As I was watching the video clipping, it went like this. The scene was of a hotel, a small restaurant where people came in for breakfast or some lunch like that. So they were there for the breakfast. And little late breakfast, there were 4 friends who had come, and all the others were also there, many, especially these 4 friends. Among these 4 friends, they were asking, "So what you will take?" And they said, "We have come here only to drink lassi." And the 4 of them ordered 4, but one was little stouter and he said, "I need 2 so they ordered 5. And at that moment, one very old lady, very miserably dressed, carrying a small potli, was near the window. And this fellow made a sign, "Come in." And he was doing "come in," and therefore that lady entered to the main door. Then he was telling, "Come inside, come to the table." And all the friends turned and looked at her with a very, very different look. They were not happy at all. And all those who were in the hotel also were looking at him, looking at this lady. This lady came in and he was trying to tell her to sit, and she sat down. And he asked her, "Will you drink lassi?" She said, "Yes." He said, "One more lassi." He ordered for her. As the lassi came in, she had some money to give. He said, "No, this is for you. You keep the money." She sat down, and this man who was sitting on the table, he got up, and his friends were watching. He also sat down to drink that lassi with him. Immediately the owner saw all this. He came. He put one chair and he said, "Let this lady sit there." He helped that lady, held her, made her sit on the chair. Also he took her potli and also kept kept at the side of the chair, and he said, "Hite basa ani tumi sudha lassi pya." You also drink the lassi at the table. And this man sat down at his place, and then he told him, "I get many customers who pay me very well. I get once in a way, and in a long time I got one human being, one person who is caring for another person." My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, we have a call to be awake. We have a call to trim. And we have a call because Jesus has arrived. Let us also pray that God may bless us. And to conclude, be ready for the return of Jesus. Jesus is coming back. Be ready. You do not know the time, the hour, or in what form we have to meet Jesus. And therefore, let us meet Jesus. We have plenty of wars, plenty of destruction, plenty of things are happening, earthquakes are happening, bomb blasts are happening, people are fighting, and many things go on, murders are happening, robberies are happening. Among all this, the call is, be ready for the return of Jesus. And how will we prepare? Let us join hands with one another. Let us love one another. Let us welcome one another. Let us be first of all good human beings, good human persons with all the qualities of Jesus. Let us also serve the poor, look after the poor, be humble, be simple, be generous. And the last line is, let us watch and be ready, always ready when Jesus comes. May Jesus be our inspiration. Please stand for the profession of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried.
He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
The prayer of the faithful. We are aware that being ready to welcome the Lord is the result of personal vigilance and of divine grace. In all humility and trust, let us implore this favor for ourselves and the rest of humankind. Let our response be,
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the Holy Father, our Bishop, and all other spiritual leaders, may they constantly inspire us with their wisdom and readiness to welcome the Lord at any time. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who believe that faith alone can gain access to eternal life, may they realize that they also need the oil of life lived according to the moral demands of their faith. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who are reaching the end of their life, may they confidently welcome the Lord, the lighted torch of a living faith, and the oil of generous obedience to God's commandments. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all the Gorai Two Zone families who are celebrating their annual Thanksgiving Mass, that they all will work together as God's one family by making personal contribution to the well-being and happiness of people of our zone. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray in silence for our personal intentions. Let us pray.
Lord graciously hear us.
Lord Jesus, you are the divine bridegroom who invites us to the banquet of eternal life. Keep our lives burning with faith and a love that we may be admitted to the feast of the kingdom, where you live and care forever and ever.
Amen.
Kindly take your hymn books, hymn number 563.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that yours and my sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for just as through your beloved Son, you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Kindly take your hymn books, hymn number 471.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the night he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her blessed spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint John Bosco, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Kindly take your hymn books, hymn number 169. Anima Christi, soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from Christ's side, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within thy wounds, hide me. Suffer me not to be separated from thee. From the malicious enemy, defend me. In the hour of my death, call me, and bid me come unto thee, that I may praise thee with thy saints and with thy angels, forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly take your hymn books to hymn number 225.
Sport.